bending scene as much as I did in Inception, I'm going to show you how to do it right here today with some simple drone footage. Okay, let's hop right into it then. So first thing you're going to do is you're going to want to basically select your clip. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to grab this clip at the top, and I'm going to bring it down into the timeline. I'm going to close this to get rid of it. Once my clip is down here, I'm going to select my clip, and I'm going to come up to the inspector, and I'm going to stabilize my clip. So the reason we want to stabilize, you just want to make sure that if there's any judders at all, that your clip will be just fine. So once your clip has been stabilized, you're going to want to duplicate your clip. So I'm going to hit Command-C, and I'm going to hit Command-V, Command-V. So I have two clips. You're going to want to take these two clips, drag them on top of each other, on top of your clip. Once they're dragged, you're going to want to turn off your middle clip. So once your middle clip is turned off, I'm going to select my top clip. You're going to want to come up here to the inspector in the top right corner, and you're going to come over to the transform section right over here. And once you get to the transform section, you're going to come to position. You're going to go to the X. You're going to type in 420, and you're going to go to the Y, and you're going to type in 420. And then you're going to want to come down and go to the rotation section, and you're going to type in 90 degrees right there. And then you're going to want to come down to the X, and you're going to type in negative 100. Okay, once you've done that, then you're going to come down to your effects panel. Okay, once you're at your effects panel, you're going to want to come down here to mass. Click on mass and go over to the draw mask. Get the draw mask, place it on top of your clip. Now I'm going to turn off my effects panel right there. Once my draw mask is on top of the clip, I'm going to come over here and I'm going to take my Bezier tool. You'll know your Bezier tool is selected by this little purple insignia. It'll be off like that, it's on like that. Okay, once that is selected, you're going to start in the bottom right corner of your clip. You're going to start, I'm going to click right there to start my first little line for the Bezier tool. I'm going to go to the left side, I'm going to click right there, and then I'm going to go up to the top. You're basically going straight to the middle. And then you're gonna basically cut this clip in half and ending it right here back at the beginning. So it cuts the clip in half. Okay, and so once that is completed, you're gonna come over here to invert mask, and over your draw mask, you're gonna click on the invert mask button. Once that, you've completed your right side for the most part, and we can move on to our second clip. The first thing we need to do when we move on to the second clip is you're gonna turn off your top clip, so hit V. Once that's off, you're going to select your bottom. So once that's off, you're going to want to select your middle clip. So I'm going to turn that on. I'm going to essentially do the same thing except for some minor details. So with your middle clip selected, you're going to come over to the transform section. Once you're in the transform section, you're going to go over to the position. So this time you're going to type in negative 420. And then you're going to come over here to the right to the Y, and you're going to type in 420. And then once you get down to the rotation, you're going to type in negative 90 degrees. And then once you get down to your scale X, you're going to type in negative 100. Okay, once that's completed, you're going to come down here to the effects panel. You're going to do the same thing that you did earlier. And we're going to take the draw mask. We're going to bring it right on top. Make sure that your draw mask and your Bezier is selected. Come over here. I'm going to start in the corner again. And then you're going to basically make another triangle going to these different corners, cutting the clip in half, and then come over to the right side once that's completed, and you're going to hit invert mask. Okay, so now it looks like your clip's almost, this video is almost done. So next thing, you're going to come down here to your timeline, and you're going to click on the top clip, and you're going to hit V to turn that on. Let's see if it's completed. Okay, so this is looking really good except for a few minor details here. If you notice that there is a white line on the bottom and right here, you can tell that the draw mask didn't actually flesh very well. So in order to fix this, you're going to want to, if this happens to yours, if you got it exactly on, I don't always get it right on. So I'm going to select my top clip, and to get rid of the white line at the bottom, it just means your draw mask wasn't actually flush, so I'm just going to drag that down. Same thing with this one. I'm going to drag that down. Once that's done, it looks like my top clip, so I'm going to drag this one. You just need to make sure that these are covering. See, you're basically making a mask, so you need to fix that. Okay, once that is completed, it looks like I finished. And there you go. Doesn't that look pretty epic or what? So this is a really cool Inception-like effect. You can do this with most drone clips. I would just be wary of getting big buildings or objects like right here if it doesn't work. That can be a big issue. Basically, if things that are far away in the distance, these shots work super good with, okay? Things that are up close, you're gonna have a harder time doing this. It's not gonna blend in as well. It's not gonna look as good. Okay, and so to finish off this clip, all I'm going to do is I'm going to come up here to the left side. I'm going to grab my adjustment layer. If you don't have one of these, I would recommend downloading an adjustment layer so you can use this, because this is really helpful for any type of work, video work that you do. So we'll come to your right side, come to your effects panel. Let's find the letterbox effect. I'm going to drag this on top of my adjustment layer. I'm going to turn this aspect ratio to 2.35. This off. Okay, and the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit Command 6. Okay, once the letterbox is on, you're gonna Command 6, come up to the top, and you can put any type of color grade that you want in here. I'm gonna add a color board. First thing you're gonna do is I'm gonna expose. So I'm gonna color correct this really quick. You can add a bunch of different effects. Like if you noticed in my video, I added a vignette, I added a little rotation to this shot. If you guys are curious about any of the other effects that I've done to these videos, leave a comment down below, like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time for our next adventure.